Hey guys, I got another repair here. This is a Sony CMT-HP29. Could use a little cleaning. One issue it does have, let me get back here, is the display is not 100%. So that's what we're going to try and fix. Plug it in. As you can see, display is very, very dim, but it does power up. It could be some dirt on the inside. It could have been smoker owned, and it also could be a bad fuse. I mean, not a bad fuse, but a bad resistor, or it could be the display is just, it's been running 24 hours and it's just burnt right out. It's the old type, so. I can show you the tape player works before we open it up. It does have sound. Put earphones on it. Sounds actually pretty good. It's all soft touch controls. Yeah, so that works. Drop that out. The CD player on this thing is actually kind of cool. If you push this button here, make sure we get that in frame. It pops out and then pops up. That's pretty cool. I've never seen that before. So let's unplug it and pop it open, see what we can find inside. One thing it doesn't have safety screws. So that's a bit of a bonus. Someone complained that I didn't have a camera, so, or a tripod. So now I'm going to take you guys with me when I take it apart. It's sort of a waste of time, but some people like that. Shows you how to take it apart. Both sides. Are you still in frame yet? The only thing I don't like about using the tripod is getting out of frame. Since I haven't used one in a while, it's going to take a while for me to get used to it. Okay, those are out. And we got your side screws here. I'm old school, I use a screwdriver, some guys use an electric screw gun, but it doesn't take much to strip these screws, so try to avoid that. Okay, there's the one side off. The unit is pretty clean, it's not that dirty, so I'm guessing it's probably been used 24 hours a day, sitting on some old man's mantle. This display is basically just burned right out, but we'll find out. Okay, yep, there's the other side. It's clean. Okay, how do we dig into this baby? We got a bottom plate. Let's take that off, see where that goes. I'm guessing that would probably be for the amplifier. That would be for the CD. That's how you can service your spindle and your pickup and everything else for the CD. And grease your gears there. So you can service that. You can basically take your ribbon cables off there and there. And take those four screws out and that will just lift right out. It probably still works. If it doesn't, then we'll take it out. I need to get the board out. And if you can see there's a lot of dust in there. That could be a problem. Jeez, I just noticed it says digital out. That's just for the CD though. Interesting. Okay, let's dig in a little bit further, see what else we can get out of it. Where do we go next? Will this come off? Just a screw there. Try this screw here. Rest just snaps on here. Come on. Don't break it in. Okay, now I'll pause it. Okay, we're working on getting the faceplate off. So we're taking apart. The CD door's got to come off. It's two screws just to get that off. Do that, you got it powered up. There you go. It's off. That would be the two black screws. And then we put back in. Okay, and plug it. There's two screws on the bottom, right beside the feet. Terrible. I'm trying to get at the. Everything works. Just got to be cleaned. We're just trying to get at the display. See why it's not working as it should. I'm guessing it's a resistor, but I could be wrong. Take this ground strap off. Okay, we're getting there. See, go on the other side here. Tape player, complete. A little bit of tape on here. Remove the tape, and we should be able to just pull the cable. Oh, what's up with that? Why would? Okay, that's weird. They put tape on it, but it doesn't look like the cable is made to come off. It's like soldered right to the board. Could be wrong. It sure looks like it's soldered in there. Yeah, it is. That's stupid. They put tape on the end of it to make it look like it's holding it. So, you know, so in transit it doesn't pop out of the slot that it's supposed to be in, and it's soldered right to the board. That's just stupid. But it's not soldered to this board. And it just came off. There you go. Yeah, so they put tape on that board, but didn't put it on that one. That's weird. Manufacturing. So there we go. There's the guts. And removing a tape deck will give you access to pretty much everything. It's looks like it's as you can see that, it's not an STK, it's a newer module. Well, yeah, it is an STK, it's a 40, it's a 40, it's an STK 403-090. I'll have to look up the specs on that. I can imagine it gets kind of warm. It's so compact in there. Alright, well, it's powered up and I'm still going here. Let's see if we can't find the problem with that display. Ouch. I actually cut myself trying to take the volume knob off. It's on there pretty good. Anyway. Yep. Okay. So, I'm just going to quickly plug it in. Make sure nothing's going to short. See if we can find out why the display isn't working. Yeah, it might work. It might not. Go. The power button. This one here. No, this one? There we go. Yeah, it is pretty dim. See that? I'll get you in frame here. Actually, I'll stop it here and then I'll. There you can notice it a little bit better. Still not 100%. I could just take this cover off if it's worn out, and this would help. Yeah, let's try that. And that's without the cover. If we just set it in just to see if it's any brighter. Are we actually trying to figure out what it is? Yeah, that's readable. That's not bad, actually. The only difference is it's not white. That's what this does, this diffuser here makes it white. Really care for it. Okay, so I'm gonna poke around a bit and then I'll start the video and see if I again see if I can't find out why it's okay. Well, two end terminals are connected directly to the transformer, so there's nothing really you can really replace on the back of the board that would make it brighter or adjust. Basically the display is just basically worn, so what you do is just basically remove this filter, and at least you can see what's going on there, and it'll last. But as you can see now, I got a volume control. I can change the input. I can see what the input is, including tape, AM/FM, and everything's still working there, so I can tune it. So that's all good. The rest is basically I'm going to clean it up. Clean the dust out of it. It's kind of dirty. And surface it from there, and probably end up keeping this unit. I like it. I have to see what it sounds like and hook some speakers up to it. I figured before we go any further with this unit, we'll give it a quick little test. It actually does make a nice little bookshelf unit. It's not the original speakers, but they'll work. Okay. So let's try the CD player first. So it's usually the first to go on these units. There we go. What's number one here? And do you put it face up or face down? I don't know. That's probably wrong. Let's take it back out. Label side's probably gotta be facing out. Okay, let's try that. CD. It's just running and running. If I'm guessing, there's probably a bad belt. It just says no disc. Oh, there it goes. No disc. There is a disc. Try this one. This might be one problem here. Oh, it's reading. It's been sitting for a while. It probably hasn't worked in a while. Still reading. Probably going to read for a while. I'm guessing that's an issue right now. It's the CD player isn't in service in a while. If it doesn't work, I'd leave that for another video because that's going to totally come apart. Let's just make sure it's not the transport. Yeah, there's an issue with the CD player. We'll look into that. We'll have to make another video for that. Oops. Let's try the tape player. I just wanted to make sure it has sound. That's all I really wanted. Tape. Turn it over. Don't see Okay, so if you guys are working on this unit, you remember the two ground straps here? They have to be put back before you do any testing. So let me drop a screw back in that and retest everything. Okay. I'm gonna test it now. Not too sure what that does. Push enter. No idea. Just want to hear what it sounds like. It sounds pretty good. It's auto reverse. Sounds really good. Okay, I'll try the CD player again. Only because it could have been a strap issue. Eject. Never know. Oh. Are you telling me it was just a strap? Of course, that makes all the difference. The lens, remember when I showed you the bottom where you can pull the transport and the lens and everything? You can hear it trying to read. So my guess. Okay, so I couldn't get it to load. So what I'm doing now is taking the caps off and removing the springs that hold this in. Oops, you see it's ready to come out. Just got two more screws. There's a get them up without dropping it in the unit. Bit of a bonus. Years of practice. And there you go. Spring. It's off. What we're going to try and do is we're going to try and clean the lens with a little bit of rubbing alcohol. Let's see if that helps. Because the problem with this unit is the fan runs 24 hours. It doesn't doesn't shut off and only turn on when it's under load, which some units it does. Okay, we don't need to remove that one. So there you go. It does have a door that closes on the lens, but it doesn't always work the way it should. Logs here. Okay, I was hoping I could find that screw that I dropped in there. Maybe I can just tip it up, it'll fall out. Yeah, losing that screw in the bottom of this unit sucked big time. I had to take the bottom right off. Luckily, it only takes that many screws to get at it. But you get an idea of the gearing in it. There's the motor. There's all the gearing. I didn't know it had a belt, which now I know. I'll see if I have a replacement. I didn't have a replacement for the belt, but it still got a lot of elasticity left in it, and so what I did is I cleaned it and cleaned the it's not slipping at all. It's good. Any dirt that might still be on it, so we're gonna shoot this back on and continue with the cleaning of the lens. Yeah, see, that had to come off. Anyway, let's put the screws back in that, and we'll get at that. Okay, we're going to give this thing a cleaning. Something wrong there. One thing I don't care about on these is that door. I usually just break it off. I really don't care for them. I'm sure they work. Sometimes they fail too, so it's gone. Let's make sure we get the spring. I want that flowing around the unit as well. There we go. Okay, so let's get something to clean. Well, guys, after all that, the CD player could not be repaired. It's the pickup. The actual assembly has to be replaced. At least you don't have to take the whole thing apart. You just drop it at the bottom. But I can't be bothered. What I do like about this unit is it's very small. And I'm going to use it on my computer. It has it doesn't have the inputs in the back for, well, basically an input. It has a function here, tape, CD, tuner, which works.
Get your certified pre-owned.
And then MD. And then there's a plug here for MD. I found this laying around. Plugged it in there. And as you can see, now I have inputs. It's a bonus. I can plug the computer directly into that and I'm good to go. So at least you got to take a look at the inside. Display is brighter now. You can see just by taking the lens off of it or the plastic cover. I could not find a way to make it brighter because it's basically worn out. But, not a bad little unit.